Hello and welcome. My name is Philip Rüdiger. I'm a senior software engineer at Anaconda, and I build open source software for developing visualizations and dashboards in Python. Today, I'm going to give you an introduction to developing deeply interactive dashboards directly from Python. In this process, we're going to be looking at four different libraries. We're going to use pandas to load and manipulate a small data set. We're going to use hvPlot to generate plots using a simple and familiar API. We're going to use HoloViews to build link selections between these plots. And finally, we're going to build a little dashboard that we can share publicly or with colleagues in this notebook, and then show you how to deploy it very easily. So as a first step, we're going to have to load some data. This is usually where a data science workflow starts. So we're going to load this data set, which is a data set of some penguins from the CSV file. And so we can have a quick look at this and see that basically it contains the species of the penguins, where they were captured and recorded, some other information such as their common length. So the common length is the bell length and the common depth, which is the width of the common, and various other information such as their flipper length, their sex, their body mass, and so on. So it's quite a rich data set that we could explore. And if you want to know more about it, you can go to this website, Power Penguins, which provides a really nice overview of the different species. So it has this nice artwork and some explanation of what the different columns actually represent. Okay, so now we have this data set and we want to start gathering some insights about it. Before we go any further, we're going to define some colors for each of these species. This will allow us to distinguish these different species very easily in our plots. So we're going to define these three colors. And now we're going to create a little scatter plot using hvPlot. If you're already familiar with the pandas.plot API, this will also be pretty familiar to you. We simply use .hvPlot instead of .plot, like you would using the pandas.plotlib API, and then declare that we want a scatter plot. And finally, we're going to say we're going to plot the common length against the common depth. We're going to color everything by the species, provide our explicit colors here, and then set some sizing options to ensure that the plot is responsive to both the window resizing and other contents around it. So we'll make sure it will fit into our dashboard very nicely at a later point. So here we get our scatter plot, and we can see here already along these two dimensions, these different species are quite distinguishable. We've got these three different clusters here, here, and here. And we can tell quite a lot about this data set already. So this is pretty nice. But there's various ways to look at this data, right? It's quite multidimensional, so you might also want to see a histogram of the body mass of these three different species. And we can already see it's not quite as distinguishable. There's significant overlap between this chin strap and the adelie penguins. And the Gen 2 penguins are generally quite a lot heavier. So what we've done here is basically plotted the body mass by the species, colored it by the species, and then basically just again set our sizing options and some options such as the alpha so that we can see what happens behind these different selections, these different histograms. Okay, so another plot that we might want to generate here is a bar plot. Here we're basically generating a bar plot of just of a count of individuals for each of the species, and that'll come in more useful later. Right now it just kind of provides a high-level overview of this data. And as a final step, we're going to generate a violin plot, which is really quite a complex plot here, which will tell us the distribution of flipper lengths between these different species, and particularly we're going to be using the split option to say break it down by female and male. And so we can see here the flipper length generally is a tiny bit bigger among the males. Not very significantly so, but certainly just in a distinguishable manner. Okay, so now using hvPlot, we've quickly, within like a single line of code, we've generated these three pretty complex plots, which tell us quite a lot about this data. But how could we reveal more about this data? So we could, for example, see here, these are clustered quite differently. But what happens if we want to know how different variables relate to each other? That's where link selections come in. We can use the HoloViews link selections function. Here we're going to make an instance of it. and then call that on a layout of the different components. So the layout here we're creating using this plus operator by just composing these different plots together. So we've got a handle on each of these plots, and because of their HoloViews objects, they can be composed using the plus operator into a layout. And finally, we say we want this in two columns. So if I run that, it's now going to run a link selections between these, which means I can now apply link selections on these plots. So for example, I now have this box selection and this lasso selection, which I can use on these plots. So as a first thing, we're going to just select a certain subset of data points. And so we can now see here how the points that we selected also are reflected in the other plots. So we can see that we've selected a pretty small subset of the overall data, less than half. We can see here that in these histograms that we've selected a smaller subset, and we can see how the flipper length differs in the subset that we selected from the overall subset, right? So for example, among the data points we've selected, the Gen 2 females have a slightly larger flipper length than the default. Okay, that's a good start, but let's now continue and see what else we can do here. So another thing we can do here is we can now, by tap and holding on the box select, we can change the selection mode. So by default, every time I make a new selection on a plot that replaces the previous selection, here we're just going to select a mode where we're appending other selections. So for that, that allows us to, for example, add a selection of these three outlier points to our selection, overall link selection. And we can see here we've added these individuals to this bar plot and the other plots as well. So this allows us to select various modes, so difference modes, the intersection between two selections, and so on. Another thing we can do is use lasso selection. So this will take a little second to the first time we use it. Again, we're going to use it to kind of very precisely select these 3 points here or 4 points here. And this provides another facility for adding a selection to our plots. But we can, in addition to selecting multiple times on a single plot, we can also do a linked selection across plots, right? So if we say we're only interested in these body masses in this middle region here, we can do a subselection here. And now all the other plots will be filtered by both by these three selections and this selection. In this way, we can kind of cross-filter very easily, get a narrower breakdown of the just the data points that we're interested in. Okay, so this is all nice. In this notebook, we've quickly generated these plots with a single function. We've kind of done this link selection, but now we want to share this with someone. So this is a big problem in many data science workflows. You have this notebook, you did some data science, you developed a model, but now you need to share this with colleagues or even the public. So how do you go from that to a deployed dashboard? Well, that's something we're going to show you here. And we're going to start by importing panel. Panel allows you to compose different plotting libraries, different logos, text, and so on into an overall dashboard. So as a first step, we're going to load this penguin Palmer Penguins logo, which is quite a nice logo, which basically allows us to kind of give our dashboard a bit of a nicer look and feel. Another nice thing that facility that panel provides is the ability to define callbacks or dependent functions which update when something else updates. So in this particular case, we're going to rerun this link selection here. We're going to rerun this particular thing here. And now what we get is a function which tells us how many of the penguins we've selected up here. So the way we've done this is we've used this panel depends decorator to say, I want to depend on the current selection of these penguins. And so then we're passed a data frame of the current selection, and we can simply count the fraction of the selected ones against the overall count of penguins in this data set, and then format it nicely using this f-string and put it in a markdown pane. And so if we do that, we get this out. And now if we apply a selection, we're going to see that value update. So let me just select this subset here. OK, so our plots updated. But we can also see that here we the overall count of penguins that we've actually selected. Another thing we're going to do, we're going to add a little header. And so we're going to combine our little logo. We're going to combine it with this count. And this is something we can put in our header of our dashboard in a minute. Another thing we're going to do is we're going to put a little welcome message here. We're just going to use Markdown for that. We're going to add some of the art we saw earlier from the website. And then we're going to give credit, first of all, for the beautiful artwork, but also for the license the data set was provided under. And so that will provide a little really nice sidebar for our dashboard. Okay, so now to remind ourselves again, we've developed these plots. We've generated these link selections. We've built a little header from these two components. We've built a little sidebar from some other components. And now we're going to compose everything together. And the way we're going to do that is using this material template, which builds on the material UI CSS framework and basically provides us a template to fill in. So again, we're going to redefine our link selections. We're going to redefine our counter. We're going to redefine our header, and then we can add that to this template. So here, basically, the material template consists of three main areas: the header, where we can simply append our header component; the sidebar, where we can add our welcome message and the little artwork and our attributions; and finally, our light selections plots we're going to add here as well. And so to quickly view this and see what this looks like. So as we're developing, we can add this show method, which is going to open a new session, a new bookie server session. So we've made this slightly too large just now. We might have to adjust that. But that's precisely what the show method is for. We can kind of adjust and play around and see what this dashboard would look like before we make it ready for deployment. So again, everything works. We've got our nice little sidebar. We've got our nice little header. Our plots are still all responsive. So if I select something here, everything responds. If I do some subselection, that also works. And you can see here that we get a little busy indicator telling us that it's still doing something. So this is all really nice. We now have a dashboard that we can happily share with someone in our company or beyond to the public. And so what we're quickly going to do is we're again going to adjust this logo a little bit because it was a bit too large. And now we're ready to deploy this thing. So the way we deploy this is we simply swap the show method for the servable method. And that's really all that we need to do. So now we can go to a terminal. I already had this running, so we're going to clear this. And now what we can do is run this command, panel serve penguins IVP bind B, and that's already enough. But this little show command will tell us to open a new browser window so we can see this thing running. And so now we have a running bokeh or panel server, which will afford all the interactivity we just saw, has all the nice visual features that we built into it, and which we can happily share. So now we could take this command, take these files, and deploy it on our favorite cloud provider, be that Anaconda Enterprise or something like AWS or Google Cloud. So in just a few steps, we've gone from doing some visualization and data science in a notebook to building this complex link selection plot to building a dashboard that we can happily share. I hope this was helpful to you. I look forward to more videos in the series, and thanks for listening. Take care. Bye.